So today I'm going to try to eat this Asako, the elitist self in personal. And that sounds kind of thick, doesn't it? But no, the elitist self being a person, a moment we go through our life, and it's just my life, it's my actions, it's my doings, it's my things, it's my everything, you know. My breath. All of that. That elitist self. But now we're like, well, in the personal of it, in the personal of it, oh, not only these things apply to me. That's the way my particular niche is. Only this action, only this maze that I walk through, these are my particular niche moments. So that makes my personal life special, makes my personal life selective, makes it different from others. So in that difference, who are you? You know, you're just, oh, I'm different. And, oh, no, I'm sorry, I'm different. I'm sorry, no, I don't walk your maze. I have my own maze, you know, my own maze that I'm on. My own maze that I walk through, and you deal with yours, and I'll deal with mine. Meanwhile, we're all walking very similarly to very, very, how shall I say it, mimicked patterns within these mazes. Many of these mazes, I mean, unless you are an astronaut and you live in outer space your whole life, as if you're born into this world and you go through the vices of have to, the vices of going to school or being homeschooled, it's still a maze that we've all entered. So we still carry those same leaves of that moment, don't we? We carry the same leaves in our maze. And how inappropriate, really, because it was supposed to be my own personal, my own selective, great place. But now, my leaves are just ordinary, like theirs. Well, my gosh, what can we do? We can go to private school. We can go to private school. We can go to some other type of schooling that makes us better. So we have maybe different type of leaves. So let's elite, you know, let's elite away from the others. You know, let's create that chasm of classism, because it starts to become classism. Just the leaves of the maze that you're walking through. Well, my goodness, I win, oh my gosh, I can say that. Yeah, I like to say it because I have been to private school, so I win. But you know what I mean, that was not what I meant. Or I have traveled, you know, so I win a prize because I traveled a lot, you know. I got selective education and I traveled a lot, you know, so I win. You know, those are my particular leaves and my particular shades of colors all year round, and they're better than yours, you know. So this is like, what is this, Ethel Merman? The Ethel Merman world of classism. Anything you can do, I can do better. That's what's going on in your maze. So there's your maze, and there's somebody else's maze over there, and they're like, well, I heard it through the grapevine. Well, I heard over the maze, the hedge of it, but that's what she's doing, or that's what he's doing. So I have to do an up, you know. I have to do an up, a successional up. And so to make yourself satisfied, you know, you have to walk that maze. You have to have that type of car. You have to have those types of leaves, in your as you're walking through this life, you know, walking through this life. I won't mention cars because that gets ridiculous, you know. That gets ridiculous. The higher and higher they go, you know, Lamborghinis, blah, 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 higher, higher and higher. I need more and more, you know. And no, we're talking just the leaves. Let's just talk the leaves walking. Even that, you know, you go to the garden nursery. Well, it's going to be down to the price, isn't it? You know, it's going to be the price. That one is $35. And that one is only $23. You know, so there's a separation right there. So as you're walking your walk through, you have a what? You have beautiful flowers that are better because they're more expensive than the ones over in their maze or the ones in that maze. I mean, is that a happiness place? Is that the success? You know, we talk about John Lennon, it was always all that. Imagine, you know, money can't buy me love or whatever. But yet it is. At that moment, you're walking through and you have this beautiful bunch of flowers that are superior to others. And so I'm like, well, is that such a... Is that such a drawback? You know, is that such a... Is that such a... I don't know, a decadent self? Yeah, it's a decadent self, you bet. Absolutely a decadent self. Because it's that separator self, you know, it's that separator. My flowers are better than yours. No, I don't even want to share those flowers, let's say. I won't even give you a cutting, you know, and greedy me. I could have. I had that opportunity yesterday, and I missed it. You know what I'm supposed to, like, be giving a human? I'm not very giving. I was supposed to make a cutting. Ugh, I missed an opportunity. And then what would it have done, you know? Then I would create, like, what, my little utopia, and I would try to give my utopia to somebody else. They could have a little smidgen of my utopia in their maze as they're walking through. Yeah, so I guess, you know, that goes down to the leveling, you know, back to communism and the socialism, and then we start leveling ourselves, you know, where we're all walking the same, I don't know, monetary tone. Well, if we all have the same beautiful flowers, it starts to make us equal again. Equal. I don't think that was the plan. For commercialism, consumerism, we can't be equal. I don't think that works. So our current society is just not set up for equality of us all having beautiful flowers. It just isn't. That's the torture that we go through every day, isn't it? Because he's going to have in his maze, or she's going to have in her maze. And then, well, it's up to you to be jealous. It's up to you to be wanton for it. It's up to you to be, hey, I have to progress like them. It's up to you to feel that spasm of anxiety. That's your choice. You don't have to ever enter into that maze because it spells their particular path. And it looked good, and you heard it on the radio that's the way to go. You don't have to. Anyway, I'm not really sure what I'm curing today. I'm not really curing anything, but I saw whales yesterday. That was really fun. I saw whales, and they were just, I don't know, feeding or circling or doing something. They didn't do the jump leap up, but they were doing all kinds of things. I saw the tail of a whale also. So it was kind of interesting. And that's in my maze now, you know, as I'm walking through. This is in my maze. I saw the whales. And, well, people in the Midwest have not seen the whales. So, oh my gosh, I'm like, a superpower now to their non-whale watching existence. You know, I have like superpowers. So I feel a little bit like, you know, again, whether I wanted to or not, I have become a successor on and over, just by watching the whales. I have become one up to the people in the Midwest who have never seen. Well, you see them on TV, but I mean for real. So, wow. So I'm privileged. You can look at yourself as privileged, or you can just look at yourself as, I'm better than you. And that's the problem. We have a lot of people out there like that. They walk around through their maze and go, I'm better than you, because I've done this, I've been there, I've done that. I've seen them, you know. Even eco-tour people, people who travel the world to go and see a wild lemur in a tree, they can still run with that successor cyclone, you know. And I know, certain people you don't maybe want to deal with, certain people you don't want to, just because maybe they're drug addicts, or maybe they're, what's the other thing? They're just cruddy people. Maybe there's just people like that. I understand that. But really, when it comes to now, you know, when you have an experience, you become a successor higher, don't you? Experiences bring you a successor higher. So, out there, Midwest time, I don't know. I'm a successor higher today, and I don't feel guilty, but it's already become another form of classism, hasn't it? Another form of education rise. We can't have people all over the world traveling just to see a whale. That's insanity. And yet that's how consumer we have become, walking through our maze, isn't it? We have to go there, and we have to do this, and we have to do the other, and we have to do this, and we have to do the other, because they have. And I heard it. I heard it over the hedge. That was the way to go. So yeah, it's just a non-stop race with the others, a non-stop race with the ones in their mazes. If you choose to just follow that same little mantra that they're following. So I don't know. Hurrah. So that's it. It's just an observance. And now I'm an extraordinary whale watching specialist. And anyway. I don't want you all getting on airplanes, though, because of it, because of my advertisement. So now what? You know, I don't want to be part of the pollutant world. Because at this point, we don't have airplanes that are smog-free. Maybe one day we will, when we have smog-free airplanes. Then off you go, then you can see those whales. But not right now. So anyhoot, I'm gonna sign off. I look awfully tired anyhow.